So guys, obviously our next topic is basics of the matching principle. So if you buy some PP&E, you got to make sure you capitalize the cost, book it as an asset, non-current asset. When you buy it, it's an investing outflow. We'll then spread out the cost over the periods benefited, the concept of depreciation. Remember, if it's intangible and it's got a finite life, then it'll be amortized. If it's a natural resource, we'll deplete it. Okay, so when a company purchases long-lived assets, PP&E, so long as it's not for sale, it's gonna be depreciated over time. Okay, so step one, record the asset on the books and depreciate it over a period of time. Now remember, you could have separate components within a particular asset, and then what you could do is, US GAAP allows this but doesn't require it, you can separate the significant components within that one asset and they have different lives, then you'll record depreciation separately for each and every significant component. That's required under IFRS, just as you know, but under US GAAP, that's optional, rarely done. Okay, if they talk about grouping assets, if they're dissimilar, then we use the term composite depreciation, or if they're similar assets, then we call it group depreciation. Either case, whether it's composite or group depreciation, we're going to take that entire class of assets and depreciate it over a single life, okay? Now, we know that the assets can be depreciated using various methods, straight line, double declining balance, sum of the year's digits, or units of production. Remember, units of production will convert that depreciation from a fixed cost to a variable cost. Alrighty, guys, when a company purchases a car, just do me a favor on the exam, don't forget to watch the dates, okay? But whenever a company buys a car, the car is recorded on the books and then depreciated over whatever period of time. In this example, the car has a cost of $50,000. Remember, that's not only the invoice, but any shipping, installation, training, everything to get it ready for its intended use. Here they tell us it's gonna be depreciated over a 10-year life. They also give us a salvage value at the end of the 10-year period of $5,500. So the first thing I wanna remind you of, if you took the cost of $50,000 and you subtracted out the salvage value of $5,500, the maximum accumulated depreciation is gonna be $44,500. All methods, straight line, double declining balance, sum of the year's digits, units of production, eventually your total accumulated depreciation will be the same. The difference with the methods is the timing of the depreciation. Okay, so our journal entries. Debit your car for $50,000 and then either credit cash or payable for $50,000. And remember, when you buy PP&E, that's an investing outflow. Okay, so now if we take the car $50,000 minus the salvage value of $5,500 divided by 10 years, our annual depreciation per year will be the same. Each and every year, $4,450. So at year one, our journal entry, debit depreciation expense, credit accumulated depreciation, $4,450. Journal entry year two, exact same thing. Debit depreciation expense, credit accumulated depreciation, $4,450. And you'll do that every single year for the next 10 years. So the total accumulated depreciation, $44,500. Don't forget, guys, accumulated depreciation is a contra asset. So it has a credit balance, but it's not a liability. It's a contra asset. So when we sell this asset at some point or take it off our books, how do we eliminate accumulated depreciation? With a debit. If the car was sold on December 31st, year 10, for $5,200, what would be our journal entry? Now remember, at December 31st, year 10, the asset has been fully depreciated. So what's gonna be our journal entry? Well, the first thing I gotta do is get that car off my books. So I credit the car for its original historical cost, $50,000. I'm gonna debit my accumulated depreciation for $44,500. I obviously have to debit my cash for $5,200. So now to make the journal entry balance, what's our plug figure? Well, our plug figure would be our loss on the sale of the car. So you have a credit for $50,000, you debit cash for $5,200, you debit your accumulated depreciation for $44,500, and then we have a loss on sale would be debited for $300. Now, the reason we have a loss on sale, don't forget, our salvage value is $5,500. So that's our ending book value. If you sell it for only $5,200, obviously you have a loss, and that loss would go on the income statement, unusual or infrequent. Okay, now let's take a look at those same facts, but now let's do DDB, double declining balance. Double declining balance, you ready? We take 2 divided by our useful life, and we get a constant rate of depreciation per year. 2 divided by 10, 20% per year. Remember with double declining balance, guys, you ignore salvage value in your calculation of your annual depreciation, but do not depreciate that asset below the salvage value, okay? So our maximum accumulated depreciation is still gonna be $44,500. So the end ending net book value has got to be $5,700. Okay, so then how do we calculate our depreciation? Well, we take our rate, 20%, multiply it by the book value at the beginning of the year. So in year one, 20% times $50,000. We haven't taken any depreciation yet. So year one, our journal entry, debit depreciation expense, $10,000. Credit accumulated depreciation for $10,000. Now year two, this is why it's called accelerated, because look at how quickly our depreciation expense is going to start to decline. Our book value at the end of year one, which is the same thing as our book value at the beginning of year two, well, that's $50,000 minus the accumulated depreciation of $10,000. So our book value now is $40,000. $40,000 times 20%, our depreciation declines from $10,000 to $8,000. So year two, debit depreciation expense, credit accumulated depreciation, $8,000. Notice the depreciation under this method is not going to be the same. It's going to decline each and every year. Okay, if you now look at our schedule here, net book value, every year we're multiplying that net book value by a constant rate, 20%. That's how we get our depreciation expense each and every year, except for year 10. In year 10, we have to have a minimum net book value equal to the salvage value of $5,500. And our maximum accumulated depreciation can only be $44,500. Therefore, in year 10, the $1,211, that's a plug figure. That's the maximum depreciation in that year so that we don't exceed the maximum accumulated depreciation of $44,500. Okay, so if you got a net book value of $6,711 and your minimum net book value is $5,500, obviously, that's how you can back into the $1,211. Okay, guys, let's take a look at another method, some of the year's digits. So the first thing we want to do is calculate our denominator. So our denominator is N, number of years, times N plus 1 divided by 2. So if you've got a 10-year life, 10 times 10 plus 1, divide that by 2, our denominator is 55, and that remains constant. In year 1, when you take your depreciation, you're going to take in your numerator your remaining useful life as of the beginning of that year. So in year one, it would be 10 divided by 55. In year two, it would be 9 divided by 55, then 8 divided by 55, and so on and so on. Every single year, that remaining useful life divided by the number of years per the sum of the year's digit formula, well, that gets multiplied by your cost minus your salvage value. Okay, and that's the way we get our annual expense. So in year one, it's 10 divided by 55 times our cost 50 minus our salvage value, 5,500. So year one, 8,091. Year two, now it's 9 divided by 55 times the 50,000 minus the 5,500, 7,282. Debit depreciation, credit accumulated depreciation. And again, if you take a look at our schedule, every single year, the rate of depreciation, it's not constant. With some of the year's digits, unlike double declining balance, the rate is not constant, it declines. The depreciation base, though, is constant, just like with straight line. Cost minus salvage value, 44,500. All the methods, what's our total accumulated depreciation expense have to be? $44,500 is the maximum amount because we have to have an ending net book value again of $5,500. Okay, now if you want to make depreciation a variable cost, so straight line, double declining balance, and some of the year's digits, depreciation is a fixed cost because it's independent of sales and usage. But if you want to make depreciation a variable cost, then you could use units of production. So the numerator, step one, we calculate a rate just like we would. The numerator is the same as straight line, cost minus salvage value. But rather than dividing by total useful life, instead we divide by total estimated usage. So our numerator, again, same as straight line, cost minus salvage value, we divide it by estimated total usage, 80,000 miles. We're going to get a rate of depreciation per mile driven of 0.55625. You then multiply that by the number of miles driven in any given year, and that's how you get your depreciation. So year one, if you drive 16,500 miles at 55 cents a mile, 9,178. Year two, if you drive the car 12,500 miles, multiply that by the same rate, 55 cents, 6,953. So in actuality, your depreciation could go up or down each year, depending upon usage. Okay, but at the end of the day, again, if you look at our schedule, total accumulated depreciation, 44,500, because our ending net book value's gotta be what? 5,500, any method. Now, you could do what's called group depreciation. Okay, with group depreciation, what do we do? Well, step number one is we're gonna calculate depreciation expense using straight line for each of these different assets. So in this example, group depreciation, similar assets, we have three different cars, one, two, and three. They have three different costs, three different salvage values. So what we're gonna do is take the first car, 50,000 minus the 5,500, divide it by 10, annual expense 4,450. Use straight line again for car number two, cost of 30 minus 5,000, divided by 16, 1,562. Repeat that for car three, original cost minus salvage value, 20 minus one, divided by 8, 2,375. So step number one is we're gonna calculate our depreciation expense using straight line. Okay, step number two, total the depreciation expense and record it. So what we would do then is take that $8,387.50, the total depreciation, debit that, credit accumulated depreciation. Remember guys, the key point is that whenever you use this group depreciation, if one of those cars is sold prior to the average service life being reached, then there's no gain or loss on the income statement. It's absorbed into the accumulated depreciation account, okay, for whatever the difference is between the cost and the selling price. So again, the key point with group depreciation, if you sell one of those cars prior to the end of its useful life, do not record any gain or loss. You gotta get that car off the books, you credit the cost, you're gonna debit cash or receivable for your selling price, and then you plug your accumulated depreciation. That'll be your debit that you will plug, but there's not gonna be any gain or loss under this method, okay? Alrighty, that wraps up our little review there. Let's take a look now at some number crunching together.